In the previous video, we discussed how the output current matching of different cells in a multi-junction device can be achieved by using an intermediate reflective layer. We will now continue our discussion of current matching. So we have discussed the phenomena that the current density is limited by the junction with the lowest current density. As a consequence, the best spectral utilization is obtained if all subcells in the multijunction are current matched. However, this does not imply that under current match conditions in a multijunction source cell, the best fill factors are obtained. Let me explain. Here we see the JV of the subcells of a tandem cell. As you can see, the subcell with the highest open circuit voltage, the top cell, has in this example the lowest current density. So the current density in this tandem cell is top cell limited. Now we are going to construct the total JV curve of this tandem cell. The current range in which the bottom cell is operating is limited by the current range of the top cell. This means that the bottom cell is operated in the indicated range. It is operating at a voltage close to the open circuit voltage under illumination. This means that the shape of the JV curve around the maximum power point is mainly determined by a single junction, in this case, the top cell. The squareness of the JV curve, or in other words, the fill factor, is mainly determined by the limiting junction, in this case, the top cell. It means that the knee around the maximum power point is relatively sharp. This can even result in higher values of the fill factor in reference to the subcells. Let's consider the situation in which the bottom cell is the current limiting cell. The current range in which the top cell is operating is now limited by the current range of the bottom cell. This means that the top cell is operated in the indicated range again. It's operating at a voltage close to the open circuit voltage under illumination. This means that the shape of the JV curve around the maximum power point is mainly determined by, in this case, the bottom cell. The squareness of the JV curve, or in other words, the fill factor, is mainly determined by this limiting junction. Again, the knee around the maximum power point is relatively sharp, resulting in high fill factors. Now, let's consider the situation in which both cells are current matched. Both cells operate in the exact same current range. This means that the fill factor of the top cell and bottom cell play an important role in the shape of the final JV curve. As a result, the knee around the maximum power point becomes dull in comparison to the bottom and top cell limited conditions. As a result, the fill factor of a current matched multijunction will be lower than the fill factor of a multijunction with a current limited subcell. Designing an optimal intermediate reflective layer requires a versatile material whose properties can be finely tuned. Hydrogenated silicon oxide is such a material. Silicon oxide is an amorphous structure of silicon and oxide atoms and crystalline silicon grains. The properties of silicon oxide are highly tunable and depend predominantly on the oxygen content of the material. The hydrogen content and crystallinity also play an important role. The exact material properties depend strongly on the deposition conditions, such as the deposition pressure, the ratio of the gas flows, and the applied RF power. Plotted in this graph is the oxygen content of a p-doped silicon oxide material as a function of the pressure during the deposition. The oxygen content decreases from over 70% at 1.5 millibar to about 30% at 8 millibars. Naturally, the decreasing oxygen content has important implications for the optical properties of the material. The refractive index of the p-doped silicon oxide increases from 2.1 to over 3.7, and the band gap energy decreases with decreasing oxygen content from about 2.4 to just under 2 electron volts. This change in the optical properties of the grown silicon oxide material is even visible to the naked eye, as this picture demonstrates. Both the n-doped and p-doped silicon oxides become visible more transparent with decreasing deposition pressure. Unfortunately, As the optical properties become less favorable with decreasing oxygen content, the conductivity actually increases. Like with many materials, therefore, the tuning of silicon oxide often comes down to a balance between the electrical and the optical properties. The versatility of the silicon oxide makes it an attractive material for various layers in a multi-junction solar cell. By adding boron or phosphor during the deposition, the material can be made P or N-type doped. The doped silicon oxides are used as the doped layers in a PIN configuration. By making the silicon oxide both highly transparent and conductive, the material is used as a tunnel recombination junction and, as we just discussed, an intermediate reflective layer. Silicon oxides have also been applied as a back reflector and even as a buffer layer or incubation layers for when a TCO with a sharp surface features is used. Moreover, by cleverly designing these layers, some of the functions can be combined. The P-doped window layer can simultaneously function as an incubation layer. The intermediate reflective layer is also a tunnel recombination junction, and the N-doped back layer functions as a back reflector. In summary, we discussed that the thickness of an amorphous silicon absorber layer is limited and that therefore the current generated by such an absorber is limited as well. In a multi-junction configuration, the amorphous absorber limits the current of the entire device. We therefore employ an intermediate reflective layer to match the output current in each of the cells in a multi-junction device. We saw how both the refractive index and the thickness of the intermediate reflective layer will influence the actual current transfer from the bottom to the top cell. Finally, we discussed the silicon oxide. It's a suitable material for an intermediate reflective layer and, due to its versatility, also an interesting material for multiple applications in a thin film solar cell.